Yeah, welcome to a typical German biogas system. We had a boom because of the energy change in Germany. Yeah, we will put off the atom.
Mm-hmm.
The atom energy.
Ну, просто если вы не знали, то Германия планирует полностью отказаться от угля и от атомной энергии. И поэтому на каждом углу здесь натыканы ветряки, солнечные панели, всевозможные биоустановки, биозаводики, биогазовые заводики.
It's running for the biogas, and you asked me for our fertilizers. So we have a lot of biogas rest, and we put it back to the field, and we have all things inside. That means NPK, so nitrogen, phosphor, kalium. And other things like, I don't know, magnesium. We start with harvest of corn silage, put it into this place.
Oh, now it starts.
And then you put these corn into this mixer. In addition to, what is it? Cow shit. I don't know the correct word. And you have also the.
But pee.
Yeah. Right. And
one question.
Everything.
Yeah. Just you do this, or farmers all around?
So let's say in normal years we just do this, but when you have not enough, crops, silage. This company is not our building here, so this is another company, and this company is asking other farmers to have enough silage to feed these.
So the company build this only for yourself, for your farm?
More or less, yeah.
Cool.
So yeah,
they. I mean, it's a corporation. They build it. You produce with the supply
they,
the.
They sell
corn?
Us these inputs. Yeah, they sell just the inputs, and they earn. They build the system, and they earn the money with.
And who operates it? Starts.
We are the operator here.
Ah, so okay.
They sell this operating from us too. We earn money with, our inputs and with the work we put inside. So
and you don't share profit from the.
No, we don't share.
Energy.
It's 100% of this company.
Okay, and when you sell the. Silos, it's more expensive, you get more money when you would sell it to somewhere else for feeding or for
no
about the
depends,
same
depends on the year, but mostly not.
So
in average of the years to sell corn silage is our most profitable job. One time per day, everything you see here inputs into these mixer and
silos and sheet goes in.
Yes.
And sheet also yours.
I mean,
from your cows.
Right.
Okay.
I can show you
Let's
how
go.
It works. And here is another mixer inside. You hear it running. It will be mixed with. Water to make it fluidable. Then you can pump it through this system, and it will pump into this building. This building is totally full, And inside are bacteria, and they produce methane.
Mm-hmm.
And with this methane, the engine here inside is running and produce energy. We talk about 550 kilowatts.
Wow.
You can see the control unit. It's a lot of electronics, really a lot. And my father is the operator here.
Uh-huh. And he needs to be here all day or?
Yeah, if you have some trouble, it happens often because of the complex system. I really look for this key, yeah? I can show you inside, yeah? Uh-huh. You see the electronical buildings or the electronical site. Uh-huh, this is the mixer outside, yeah, and this green means it's running, yeah.
Uh-huh.
It's mixing, and then it will be put into the noisy mixer inside, and then it will be pumped to the big building, to the green one. You see, you have small pressure, it's just 0.5 millibars
mm-hmm.
on it, and the temperature is important for the bacteria. Yeah, and it's producing the methane, and here you see the engine is running 500, more or less 50 kilowatts. And this is the rest building. Here we put this out in the spring and bring it back to the field.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. You can say you have four.
So you don't need to buy NPK at all?
Yeah, we need two, but
not that much.
Let's say 50-50.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. If inside 1 ton of this material is about 4 kilogram of nitro.
Oh.
Yeah, and you have, I don't know, one, let's say 2 kilogram of phosphor.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know about the calcium.
It's in 1 ton. Okay.
Yeah. So.
Okay.
I will show you inside, just to have an overview. What's crazy here? This is
oh
whole,
my god!
The whole thing is about electronics. See,
it's
all
warm.
Yes. Yeah. There's no warming inside.
Uh huh. I don't need it.
It's warm. from this? You click click, then is something running or shut off?
Turns on or shuts off. Mm-hmm. Right. Unbelievable. Yeah, click, uh-huh. Click. And it runs 24 hours.
Yeah.
Every day.
Every day. Wow. If you have some problem, you can push this button to say
stop.
Hello, I'm here. Uh-huh. I solved the problem or not. Yeah, it's a video. Everything is on the video.
So nobody could stole your shit. You can control it.
Hey, you're laughing, but some days some people ask me for the shit for his own garden.
Uh-huh.
Good, and this is the engine inside. It's a V12. Yeah. Mm-hmm. V12 engine. It's loud. Here on the display, the main things for this engine is always running about 1500 RPM. It's important to have the 50 Hz frequency for the system.
Electricity.
Right. You see the energy. Yeah.
Some other and it things. Works on methane.
Yeah, just with methane.
And never stops.
Hopefully. 2 days ago it was down for 24 hours.
Ow.
And this is not that good, so this company will lose money for sure, and our village will cool down, and all people is calling me, oh, what's wrong with the...
Give us warm.
Give us warm,
So you are responsible. How many people in village?
It's just about 90.
Ah, 90 people. Yeah. So it's not that big.
Not a big one. Yeah, I explained it earlier. That is typical for this area, about 100 and 300 people per village.
Mm-hmm.
So let's say a village to village is always about 3 to 5 kilometers.
Uh-huh.
And in other areas in Germany, in the south mainly, you have much more bigger villages and they are closer. So you have, more people in the area. Yeah. If this system, if it has a problem and the engine is shut off, it's always producing methane. Yeah,
uh-huh.
Because the bacteria don't say, oh, I go to sleep. And then you have to need these fire, fackel, I don't know what is. You see this spilling and...
You lit it
and
it burns.
This is not good, you burn money.
Sure, I understand.
More or less, but it's a lot of water on the top.
Mm-hmm.
This is not, but it's black.
But it's not real.
The advantage also for this is when you put the cow shit, this is stinky.
Mm-hmm.
The cow shit is stinky, and after the methane is outside, it's more or less without smelling.
Really?
It's not smelling, yeah?
Yeah, absolutely.
Do you smell something?
Absolutely.
So this is more or less an advantage because no one will kill you when you drive Sunday pig or cow shit because it's not...
Yeah, I mean, the silo smells more than the shit.
That's what you're smelling here. Right, and here I can show you something. This is for these rest material. We put it into, we mix it, and then the nitrogen inside will be stabilized.
Mm-hmm.
So we have not so much losses in the spring. When we start, we have, you can easily imagine this building is in February totally full. and then you have to take it out. But in February, not every plant needs that much nitrogen, and then we take this inside, so the nitrogen is stable for some weeks with plant growing. Uh-huh. So we reduce losses. If this engine is go out, it takes, let's say, 30 minutes, and then the pressure is too high and you have to put on the fire here. Normally, the main idea of a biogas system was it to put these rest stuffs from,
cows, not the silos, pigs, but just the rest.
And mm-hmm. just take this inside. But with the new law in, I don't know when, after for new energies, new energy law, let's say it, it was profitable to put corn silage into these new buildings.
Corn for
but it's not
energy.
The law, it's the law was changed, I guess, in 2012. And since this year, this boom of these systems stopped.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so you get the money from the government for for this energy here.
Now they don't want to pay much money.
Now you get... Normally it would be better to take it off more straight, mm-hmm. because you see this means losses what you see.
Uh-huh.
But the company gave us not the tool for it, yeah? Because they pay us for the telehandler.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we have a contract uh-huh. about 150 hectares uh-huh. of corn.
Okay.
And it is our business to grow the corn. And when the corn is done, they will call a contractor, and the contractor will harvest.
And they harvest for their money, corn.
Yeah.
You don't need to do this.
Right.
You just plant it, grow it
right.
enough to run this mm-hmm. factory.
Weight system. Everything inside was moving over this.
Mm-hmm.
And after that, we know how many corn we sell to this buildings.
So they need weight, a certain weight or certain number of hectares. You can.
We have contract about hectares.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, and when you see in the summer, oh shit, it's not enough rain or it's not enough. They call other farmers here in this area if they're interested to sell the corn or other things like grass to these buildings here. You see, because of the bad harvest we had this year too, normally it's more than double
uh-huh.
of silage from corn. They bought also, I guess it's wheat or was rye.
Mm-hmm.
They scramble it and it's also put into.
Also works for the energy.
Yeah, you cool. can put everything what is from the nature, you can put inside. With some stuffs you have to take care about some chemical reactions inside.
Mm-hmm.
Someday, one time we put rapeseed, but green, as a whole plant inside, and you had problems with a lot of, was it Schwefel? Schwefel? I don't know what is the translation. Yeah, good.
Perfect, I like it. I really enjoy it in something really new.
Yeah.
Let's go back.